Hello children, hope you are safe, healthy and happy at home and are making best use of the learning opportunities which is being provided to you during this lockdown period, that is through the electronic media. Let me just go back to the two themes covered in the two classes which we had on the Doordarshan, and I am sure you must have watched both the classes. In the first class we had learned to develop our reading skills and also learned the various tips to improve our reading skills. And in the next class, we had learned about the writing skills, the formal letter, the format of writing a formal letter and the various methods of writing a format letter. And we had also discussed how better we can develop our reading skills and what can we do to make our writing creative. Today, let's try to understand the first lesson of your prose, First Flight, A Letter to God by G.L. Fuentes. This chapter or story is about a farmer, and let me tell you that this story is based on a Latin American character, and it is based on that scene, that particular place. So here the main character of the story is Lencho, who is a poor farmer. This story revolves around the idea of unquestionable belief in something, unshakable faith. So let's see, what is the unshakable faith that Lencho has and how is it helpful to him? Let's move on to the story. Children, if you have your textbook, you may please open the first lesson and just have a look while we are trying to read and comprehend the chapter. And also the lesson will be on your screen. A Letter to God. The house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. From this height, one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with the flowers that always promised a good harvest. The only thing the earth needed was a downpour, or at least a shower. Throughout the morning, Lencho, who knew his fields intimately, had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. Now children, let's look at some of the words in the paragraph which you might find difficult. Crest means top of a hill. Dotted, full of. Downpour means heavy rain. Intimately means closely. Let's now go back to the paragraph and try to understand this. Lencho's house was the only house in the entire valley. As you can see on the picture there on the screen, his house was on the top of a low hill, and from there he could see his fields. He had a corn field, and his corns were ready to be harvested, and he was expecting a very good harvest from his field. And the only thing requested for the good harvest was a very good rain, a heavy downpour. And Lencho was desperately waiting for the rain to come, and he was very happy that he is going to get a very good harvest this year. And he had known his fields very intimately, and that day he was just looking towards the northeast expecting the rain. Now let's move to the next paragraph. Now we are really going to get some water. The woman who was preparing supper replied, "Yes, God willing." The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house, until the woman called to them all, "Come for dinner." It was during the meal that, just as Lencho had predicted, big drops of rain began to fall in the northeast. Huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. The air was fresh and sweet. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. And while he returned, he exclaimed, there aren't raindrops falling from the sky. They are new coins. The big drops are 10% pesos and the little ones are fives. Let's look at some of the meanings of the words. Exclaimed, cry out suddenly in surprise, strong emotion or pain. Predicted, known beforehanded or foreseen. Supper, light evening meal, or you can even say dinner. Pleasure, a source of happiness. Now let's try to understand the stanza. Here, Lencho is talking to his wife, the woman mentioned in the paragraph. He is talking to his wife and saying that we are going to get some water. That means it's going to rain and we are going to get a good harvest, and you know, it will be very useful for our crops. The children were playing outside and his wife called them for a supper or to have dinner. And while they were having dinner, sitting for dinner, suddenly, as Lencho had predicted, the drops of rain started to fall in the northeast. And huge mountains of clouds could be seen. And suddenly the air was fresh and sweet. And Lencho, as he was expecting the rain, so went out and he was so happy. And just for the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body, because he was so happy, and he exclaimed. This exclamation was out of happiness because it started raining according to his expectation, and he started considering these drops of rain as you know, pesos, the big drops as 10-cent pesos and the small ones as fives. With a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers, draped in a curtain of rain. But suddenly, a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain, very large hailstones began to fall. These truly did resemble new silver coins. The boys, exposing themselves to the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. It's really getting bad now, exclaimed the man. I hope it passes quickly. But it did not pass quickly. For an hour, the hail rained on the house, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield, on the whole valley. The field was white, as if covered with salt. The farmer now starts worrying and hopes that the storm gets over quickly, which, to his utmost disappointment, didn't. The hailstones covered the entire valley, including the house, garden, hillside, and the cornfield. It made everything look so white that it seemed as if it was covered with salt. Now, let's look at some of the word meanings. Regarded means consider or think of in a specified way. To consider, draped means adorn or cover or wrap someone or something. Here, covered. Hailstones means a small pellet of ice that falls during a hailstorm. Resemble means to have a similar appearance. Now let's try to understand the paragraph. Now when the rain started falling, Lencho was very happy and he looked at his cornfields, which was covered with the curtain of rain. But suddenly what happened? Suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with it hailstones, and then hailstones, the balls of ice started falling on his field, everywhere, not only on his field, his house, the garden, everywhere, and destroyed his fields completely. This made Lencho very sad. Not a leaf remained on the trees. The corn was totally destroyed. The flowers were gone from the plants. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field and said to his sons, a plague of locusts would have left more than this. The hail has left nothing. This year we will have no corn. That night was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing. There's no one who can help us. We all will go hungry this year. Now you can see the picture of Lencho standing in his fields, which was totally destroyed. Now let's look at the word meaning. Plague actually is a dangerous disease which spreads very fast and kills many people. It could also be a destructively numerous inflow of multiplication of a harmful animal or infestation. Locust means insects which fly in big groups and destroy crops. You can see the picture of a locust there on the screen. Now let's try to understand this paragraph. Now what happened as a result of this storm and in this hailstones? Not even a leaf was there on the trees. His cornfield was totally destroyed and the flowers were also gone from the plants. Now Lencho was very sad and he was discussing with his family now what would happen to them throughout the year, because a farmer's life and his livelihood depends upon his harvest. So when there would be no harvest, they are going to starve the whole year. They won't have anything to eat. They would go hungry. So this was a matter of great concern for Lencho. Now let's see what happens next. But in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope, help from God. Don't be so upset, even though this seems little a total loss. Remember, no one dies of hunger. That's what they say, no one dies of hunger. All through the night, Lencho thought only of his one hope, the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, sees everything, even what is deep in one's conscience. Lencho was an ox of a man, working like an animal in the fields, but still he knew how to write. The following Sunday at daybreak, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to town and place in the mail. It was nothing less than a letter to God. Now let's look at the word meanings. Solitary means lonely or existing alone. Lencho's house was the lonely house there in that valley. Conscience means an inner sense of right or wrong. Ox of a man means hardworking. Lencho was an ox of a man. He was very hardworking. Daybreak means the time in the morning when daylight first appears. Now let's go back to the paragraph and try to understand it. Now, the only house in the valley, that means all the members of Lencho's family, had only one hope. And what was that hope, dear children? The help from God, because there was no other house there in the valley and no one who could help Lencho in this situation. So only God could help them from going hunger throughout the year. And the whole night Lencho could not sleep and he was thinking of the help from God, and he knew that God would definitely help him, and God helps all his creatures. And there is no doubt Lencho was a very hard-working person. He was an ox of a man, that means he worked very hard in his field like an animal. And what did he do the following Sunday at the break of the day? Early in the morning he began to write a letter. And whom did he write a letter to? He wrote a letter to God. And then he would himself go back to the post office and post the letter. God, he wrote, if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crop comes because the hailstorm. He wrote to God on the envelope, put the letter inside, and still troubled went to town. At the post office, he placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it into the mailbox. One of the employees, who was a postman and also helped at the post office, went to his boss laughing heartily and showed him the letter to God. Never in his career as a postman had he known that address. The postmaster, a fat, amiable fellow, also broke out laughing, but almost immediately he turned serious and, tapping the letter on the desk, commented, "What faith! I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this letter, starting up a correspondence with God." Let's look at the word meaning. Pesos here means it's a currency, the basic monetary unit of Mexico, several other Latin American countries, and the Philippines. Amiable means friendly and pleasant. Correspondence, communication by exchanging letters with someone. Now let's try to understand the paragraph. Here, what did Lencho write to God? That he needed 100 pesos in order to, to sow his field again and to start back his livelihood. So he said that God was his only hope, and so God only could help him, and he wrote a letter, put it in an envelope, and went to the post office and dropped the letter in the mailbox. And what happened after that? One of the employees, who was also the postman, he started laughing. Letter to God. In the history of the post office, he had never seen such an address. Address to God. So he took the letter to the postmaster. The postmaster also laughed in the beginning, but after some time was really shocked and surprised to see the faith that the writer of the letter had on God. So he wished he could also have such unshakable faith in God. So what did he do? Let's see. So in order not to shake the writer's faith in God, the postmaster came up with an idea. Answer the letter. But when he opened it, it was evident to answer it, he needed something more than goodwill, ink and paper. But he stuck to his resolution. He asked for money from his employees. He himself gave part of his salary, and several friends of his were obliged to give something for an act of charity. Let's look at the word meaning. Goodwill means friendly, helpful or cooperative, feelings or attitude. Resolution means a firm decision to do or not to do something. Obliged means grateful. Evident, clear. Stuck means remain firm. Let's try to understand the paragraph. So the postmaster decided to help the writer because he was greatly moved by his gesture, his unshakable faith. So, but he soon realized that in order to answer the letter, only goodwill was not enough. He needed something else. So he decided to collect some money from his employees, and he himself contributed a part of his salary, and then thought of sending this money to the writer of the letter. It was impossible for him to gather together the 100 pesos, so he was able to send the farmer only a little more than half. He put the money in an envelope addressed to Lencho, and with it a letter containing only a single word as a signature, God. The following Sunday, Lencho came a bit earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. It was the postman himself who handed the letter to him, while the postmaster, experiencing the contentment of a man who has performed a good deed, looked on from his office. Lencho showed not the slightest surprise on seeing the money. Such was his confidence. But he became angry when he counted the money. God could not have made a mistake, nor could he have denied Lencho what he had requested. Now, the word meaning, contentment means satisfaction. Denied means to refuse. Now, when the postmaster tried to collect the money, He could not collect the 100 pesos. He could only collect 70 pesos. So in order to help the man who had such a strong faith in God, he decided to send the 70 pesos. So he put the money in an envelope and wrote only a single word as a signature, God. The following Sunday, Lencho came a bit earlier to the post office to see whether God has replied his letter. And the postman was also very happy. You know, he experienced the contentment. Contentment means he was very happy that, you know, he has done some good deed by helping the man. And he was also watching Lencho from his office. Lencho did not show a slightest sign of surprise, you know, that God has answered my letter and I have received the money. Instead, when he looked at the money, he became angry. He saw only 70 pesos were there. So children, he had such an unshakable faith in God that he said to himself, God cannot make a mistake. Neither God can deny Lencho what he had asked. That means he believed that God must have sent him the 100 pesos. Let's move ahead. Immediately, Lencho went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. On the public writing table, he started to write with much wrinkling of his brow, caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp, which he licked and then affixed to the envelope with a blow of his fist. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it. It said, God, of the money that I had asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Send me the rest, since I need it very much. But don't send it to me through the mail, because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks, Lencho. Now let's look at the word meaning. Wrinkling means frowning. Children, when you frown, when you are either angry or when you are, worried, you know, so the expression on your face when you frown. Affixed means fix, firmly attach. Crooks means someone who has committed a crime or fraud. Here, immediately what did Lencho do when he found only 70 pesos in the envelope? Children, he went to the window to ask for a paper and ink. And, you know, frowning, he started to write the letter to God again. What did he write this time? He wrote to God that, you know, I had asked you 100 pesos, but only 70 pesos have reached me. So God, please send me the remaining amount because I need them very badly. But what did he say? He said that please don't send it through the mail because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks. That means he did not trust the post office people. He called them a bunch of crooks. He feels that they have cheated him. God had sent him the 100 pesos, but the post office people have taken the 30 pesos and sent him only the remaining 70 pesos. So, children, what do we learn from this? That Lencho had such an unshakable faith in God that he could not trust anyone else, not even the post office employees who had helped him. Dear children, I'm sure you must have understood the story. If you remember, while discussing the reading skills, I had taken one small passage from this very lesson, which spoke of the help the people of the post office provided to Lencho. And now we read the whole story and try to comprehend it. Now, children, you need to read the lesson again and again, as I had told you, since we have discussed the word meanings and since we have tried to comprehend the story. Now, if you read again, it will be easy for you to understand the story and also about the main character, that is Lencho. Dear children, the questions that are asked in the CBSE question paper from your literature part, for that you need to really understand understand the story very well, understand the chapter, understand the poem, so that you will be able to answer any question that is asked from the story. Therefore, you should not limit yourselves to the textbook questions or the questions which are there in your guide. You need to be prepared to answer any questions. And how can you do this? You can do this only if you read the chapter again and again, read the story again and again, understand the theme well, understand the characters very well, and the message that the story conveys, then you will be able to answer any questions. For example, here we had discussed when we had discussed the reading skills also, how you are supposed to make notes while you are reading the lesson. I hope you remember. After every paragraph, you need to make notes, write down the meanings, referring to dictionaries, and write the qualities of the character that has been mentioned. For example, we had written the qualities of Lencho that day. Isn't it? He was hardworking, he was loving, caring, unshakable faith in God. At the same time, he also has some negative qualities. Isn't it? That you might have noticed while we were reading the chapter. What were the negative qualities? He did not have trust in the post office employees, and he called them a bunch of crooks. He said they had cheated him. And also, when he received the money from God, he never questioned, you know, how has God sent him the money? How is it possible that God could send him the money? So he did not have the courtesy to question that how has the money reached him. And instead of being grateful to the post office employees, he started blaming them. So, you know, many characters in the stories might have both positive and negative qualities or attributes. So you need to write both of them. And while you're making notes, you should try to understand the character in a better way. Because as I told you, you may be asked to write a character sketch of the characters, or you may be asked to write a pen portrait of the character. Describe that person. So when you read each paragraph, make notes, write down the word meanings, and write down the main points, the key points of the paragraph. And if the character is mentioned in the particular paragraph, you can write about that character. For example, it could be Lencho, it could be the postmaster, you know, or the post office employees, you know, what qualities they had. That you could note down so that it will help you. So children, this story has an irony. Irony we had discussed while we discussed the reading skills also. But still, I would like to repeat today. Irony is a situation, or it's a figure of speech, where what you say is totally different from what you mean. You want to say something else, but you are saying something else. You know, the intended meaning is different. So here, what is the irony in the story, children? Here, the post office people had helped Lencho, isn't it? They had collected money and they sent him so that it could help him for his survival. But what did Lencho do? Lencho had written a letter to God and he was expecting God to send money. So when he received the money, what did he do? He complained to God that these post office people are a bunch of crooks, and he blamed them. He blamed them of cheating. So instead of thanking the people who had helped him, he started blaming them. That is the irony. You know, he's asking God to send him the remaining amount. So he had trust in God, but not in the people who had helped him. So that is the irony. So children, maybe there could be a question on irony. What is the irony in the story? Right? So you can explain according to the marks that is carried in the question. 2 marks means you can just explain it in 2 or 3 sentences. And if it is of 8 marks, then you can write in detail how he had written a letter to God and how the post office people had responded and how he blamed them at last. Right? So that was the irony. Right? The people who were helped were being blamed. So this could be one kind of question, and one kind of question could be the character sketch, as I had told you, and one part could be the help rendered or offered by the post office people. So dear children, I would request you to read the chapter again and again, make notes of each paragraph and try to understand the whole chapter, and also try to understand how many parts does the story or lesson carries. For example, this could be the first part could be about Lencho's field and his qualities, what kind of a person was he and what was he expecting. The second part could be the destruction caused by the storm and the hailstones, and the third part could be Lencho's writing letter to God, and the fourth part the help offered by the post office people and Lencho's response. So if you divide the lesson into portions or parts like this and try to understand, and then there is no doubt that you cannot answer any questions asked in the board. You will be able to answer any questions. So you need to prepare yourself in this way. That is, reading is very important, reading of the chapter again and again. I hope, children, you would read the chapter again and again and make notes, and in the same way you will do for the other chapters also. Try to read them, and in the next class we will be back with another topic. Until then, stay safe, stay happy.